Hi, my name is Tracy Hansen, and I'm a mixed media artist living in Southern California. Welcome to a corner of my home studio. I want to say, first of all, that I'm very happy to be part of this Give a Girl a Journal project. And the reason is that journaling has been a daily part of my life for a very long time. For instance, here's a little secret. I'm filming this in front of a piece of furniture, a Husky tool cabinet, that I use to store all my journals. That's how obsessed I am. So with the exception of two drawers that have some art supplies in them, the rest of them are filled with all my types of journals. And I do keep a few, and I'll share with you a little bit about that quickly. But first, I just wanna say how I started journaling. I believe I started journaling, I don't know exactly when, but I think I was a preteen, somewhere around 9 or 10. And I was of that generation where a girl was given a little journal with a lock and key, and I got one of those and I loved it. And I started journaling, and it was very fun. It wasn't too long though before I started getting a little scared about somebody might read it. So I'd write in journals sporadically, but it wouldn't be too long before I'd rip them up or burn them or something like that. But I always had that desire to do it. And probably the reason is that I was an only child. I was really shy. Somewhere along the way, I've gotten over that. But back then, I was really shy. An only kid, I was taller than everyone else, so I was different. So that journal kind of gave me a place, you know, to put all my teenage angst. And it wasn't silly, it was a good thing for me. It was the place to put it all because I didn't have a sister to share it with. And I did that for, so you know, several years. But it probably wasn't until I moved out on my own when I went to college at 18, where I started journaling in earnestness. I mean, every day. But I still kept it under lock and key. I still do in my cabinet. It's a key locked thing, but I don't feel too weird about it anymore. I've come to understand that the things that I write in my journal are the feelings that I'm having in the moment, and 5 minutes later they're gone. But it still is the place where I work out my feelings. It's the place where I do a lot of planning and put my to-do list. It's the place where I process after I've had a big happening in my life or a big project that I've just completed. Let me show you some of the different kinds of journals that I keep. This is a small stack of my art journals. So you can see that I keep them in every size and shape. So they can be left in my studio, they can be toted along. And by art journaling, if you don't know what I mean, that is pages where you literally paint and collage and play. So that's one form of expression for me, and that is really fun and portable way for me to do some art on the go or in just the few minutes that I might have. The other type of journals that I would keep are also along the artistic line. These are more like sketchbooks that I keep where I play more with pen and pencil and sketch out ideas that I have. As you can see, I'm still kind of addicted to color, so that goes there. I have smaller ones that I can keep in my purse. And speaking of that, I always have some sort of notebooks in my purse with all my to-do list, and that's a real portable thing. This is the place that I catch ideas that I don't want to lose that may get transferred into my sketchbook later. But this is the thing. These are the daily things. These are the writing, the traditional journal keeping, and that's probably what I do most regularly on a near daily basis. I have a whole ritual around that. I could do a whole video series about journaling because obviously I like it. Now, in the beginning, it was something that I kept in notebooks that didn't scare me too much to write in, you know, composition notebooks or spiral notebooks, things that weren't too precious that allowed me to write my daily morning pages. without feeling too scared to mess something up. Well, somewhere along the way, I got over that and I started wanting to make my journals be more precious and be more special. It was all part of the ritual to me. So I have become addicted to these beautifully hand-bound leather notebooks that I get at Jenny Bick. They're kind of expensive, and for me, that's important for me. I want precious. Here's a new one that I got just yesterday. So it's filled with beautiful papers, and I do use everything. I love to write with a fountain pen. I also use white ink on colored pages that fall within these kind of books. So that for me is something I want. I want the precious journal. That is something that maybe in the beginning you won't want if this is new to you. So I just wanted to share that with you, how that might be a little bit different than most daily journalers. That is my time. It's where I allow myself to process my feelings. I can plan my day. I can hear myself think. That's what it's done most for me. Journaling has allowed me to hear what I really think about myself, my life, my plans, and that has been an invaluable experience for me. I hope that this project gives you the kind of joy that journaling has given for me. I hope that it allows you to find your voice, to hear yourself think, and that it becomes a meaningful practice for you too. Thank you.